Hi, I'm Dr. Sujatha, Head of Embryology, NOVA IVF Fertility. In NOVA, how do we prepare embryologists to handle important tasks such as creation of embryos? Most of the embryologists, almost 60 to 70% of our embryologists are actually masters in clinical embryology. They have had a background or academic knowledge in embryology. But when they come to us, we put them through a rigorous induction schedule where we assess not only their technical skills but also their ability to be a team player and their time management skills and other aspects, other qualities which are very important to handle such a fine task. So what happens basically is an embryologist would be assigned to a lab and would be assigned a supervisor, and the whole process might take around 6 to 8 months, where they will have to handle procedures first with non-viable eggs, which are actually to be discarded material, and each procedure will have a benchmark. Say for example, if they are doing removing of cumulus cells from the gametes, then they'll have to practice it. There is a time limit that they can take only few minutes to handle the procedure. They should not damage the eggs. And only if they cross that benchmark, they are actually moved to viable eggs. Here again, all these are done under the supervision of experienced embryologists. Now, what happens like after, so they go stepwise, picking up of gametes, then cleaning those gametes, like, you know, preparing the gametes for fertilization, then the actual process of fertilization, evaluation of embryos, maintenance of the equipment in the laboratory, quality control and quality assurance in the laboratory. Every single procedure they have to spend time, they have to show that they have performed all these procedures, and then only after doing that they are actually moved to the next one. So as I said earlier, the whole process for an excellent embryologist, it takes around 6 to 8 months, but in some cases it can even go up to a year. After that, they are put in laboratories where they work with senior embryologists, and once they are confident of handling the system themselves, then they are allowed to handle independent cases. Sometimes they are even moved to laboratories where they can handle the whole laboratory by themselves.